Welcome to this lecture series dedicated to Professor Hastings Wilfred Okoth Ogendo, born in 1944, a professor of law and a guru in the land jurisprudence from the University of Nairobi Faculty of Law. The jurisprudence, theory, and the science of law. In any way, we cannot claim to practice the law if we don't claim to have the knowledge of it. We must begin with the knowledge of law, and that is what we refer to as the jurisprudence. Lesson number one of this lecture series shall be concerned with the general introduction and also the historical development of the jurisprudence as it is known today. And that is the reason for which I want to dedicate this lecture series to Professor Okoth Ogendo. 1.2, our learning outcome will be told by the following learning objectives. The first objective is to understand the knowledge of law. Number two is to explain the legal theories that come along together and different legal methods that have been developed along different generations. Number three is to familiarize ourselves with the jurisprudence, the knowledge of law, the history of law, the philosophy of law, the science of law, the sociology of law, and what has been generated by law scholars over a long period of time. The fourth objective here is to engage with the reality of the critical legal studies, the critical thinking, because any university discipline is backed by the critical thinking and a thorough and well understanding of a discipline or of a subject, and to be in a position to apply that particular subject to the reality. This kind of understanding brings us to the question of how to define the jurisprudence. Let us see how it appears, because the definition of the jurisprudence may also be very bothersome or very problematic when it comes to different scholars looking at the same wording from different angles. However, the truth remains the same. The Black's Dictionary that most of us lawyers rely on as our point of reference for definitions and academic knowledge defines the jurisprudence beginning with the word knowledge. Knowledge is highlighted as a concept under the explanation of Black's Dictionary, which means an awareness or understanding of a fact or a circumstance. That is what lawyers engage in, how to understand any fact, any circumstance. And in doing that, they come up with the knowledge about it. That is the reason for which we say you have the knowledge of something. When English jurists say that you have the kernel knowledge of somebody, it means that you have had factual contact, that is, sexual contact with that individual. That knowledge understood from the legal perspective or from the lawyer's perspective, may be referring to what you are able to explain and you are able to testify and provide evidence to. However, knowledge goes beyond just having contact and relationship with something. It goes beyond what our eyes can meet, what we can perceive through our five senses, but it reaches out also to the insights, what we can conceive using our power of thinking, the power of reason. This is where the philosophy of law bases its core argument, and the philosophical inquiries dig around the area of reasoning, the power of the mind, our conscience that should tell us what is good from what is bad. The senses receive the signals that are brought into the brain through the nervous system. But even this kind of reality can be defective. They could also be appearances. Just as the saying goes, dreams are never true because they are dreams. They may be faulty. They may be defective. They may be just appearances in the mind which have got nothing to do with the reality as it is and as it ought to be. This is where we are going to base our topic on the jurisprudence. The learning outcome of this first lesson is to expose you to the general conception without which your learning of the jurisprudence may be somehow problematic. But remember that the jurisprudence is now defining the practice of law today in the superior courts and also in the subordinate courts. At the Supreme Court, the Court of Appeal, the High Court, lawyers rely and ride so much on the philosophical conception of law, and that is what we are based on. Thank you for watching, and thank you for being here. Bye for now.